Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa, and today I'm making strawberry panna cotta. Today I'm making strawberry panna cotta. Now, I won't talk about panna cotta, so if you would like to learn more about this sweet treat, check my post about it. Link is in the description below. However, I have discovered quite a few interesting things about strawberries. For example, if the encyclopedia La Russe Gastronomique is to be trusted, strawberries were cherished as medicinal plants even in ancient Rome some 2 centuries before Christ. Imagine that. Fast forward to medieval times. Alchemists were considering strawberries to be a panacea, universal cure for every illness. Until 18th century, only available were wild strawberries, but then people started to cultivate and grow them in their gardens, so today we have no less than 103 species of strawberries. By the way, when you think of strawberries, I bet that the only color you imagine is red, right? Wrong. Apart from being red, strawberries can be yellow, blue, purple, white, and black. Well, not exactly black, you know, like a tar, but of deep dark violet color. Anyway, amazing, right? Now, some more facts. Strawberries are the only fruit with seeds on the outside, and every strawberry has on average some 200 seeds. They are the members of the rose family, so don't forget to stop and smell the strawberries at least once a day. They are also very healthy, low in calories, high in vitamin C, B6, K, fiber, folic acid, potassium, and amino acids. They contain more vitamin C than oranges. Now here's a weird one. Believe it or not, there is a fear of strawberries and it is called fragaria phobia. A fear of strawberries, imagine that. And finally, there is this thing called la vepionese. Ha, huh, I got you there, haven't I? Now what the fudge is la vepionese? Well, it's a beer, more precisely a Belgian beer made of strawberries. You see, there is a Belgian village of Vepion, and the people there love their strawberries so much that they have a museum dedicated to this lovely, delicious fruit. And in that museum, there is a shop where you can purchase many different strawberry products, like jams, liqueurs, etc., and the strawberry beer La Vepionese. Now, as far as I'm concerned, a line has to be drawn somewhere. So I say, forget about the beer and let's make some yummy, sweet and delicious strawberry panna cotta. As usual, the recipe is on my site and the link is down below. To make strawberry jelly, I'll soak gelatin in cold water. As soon as my gelatin softens, I'll take it out and squeeze to get rid of the excess water. I've put strawberry puree into a bowl. I'll add sugar and stir with a whisk. I will heat up this mixture in the microwave. My puree is hot. I'll add soaked gelatin and stir until it melts. I've lined 15 by 15 centimeters, which is 6 by 6 inches square pan with plastic foil. I will pour my jelly into the mold and shake the mold to distribute the jelly evenly. I'll put it in the fridge for about 1 hour until it sets. My jelly is set. Now I will cut out heart shapes using my small heart-shaped cutter. I will stick my jelly hearts onto the insides of my glass and I'll put one heart at the bottom. I'll prepare 3 glasses and put them in the fridge while I make panna cotta. To make panna cotta, I'll soak gelatin in cold water. As soon as my gelatin softens, I'll take it out and squeeze to get rid of the excess water. I've put milk into a measuring cup. I'll add sugar and vanilla extract and stir to combine. I will heat up this mixture in the microwave. My milk is hot and now I'll add soaked gelatin and stir until it melts. Then I will gradually add cold cream, stirring constantly with a whisk. I will leave this mixture to cool down a bit. My mixture is lukewarm and now I will carefully pour it into my glasses. Make sure that your panna cotta isn't too hot when you pour it because it will melt your strawberry jelly. I will put my glasses in the fridge for a couple of hours until panna cotta sets completely. I've put the remaining strawberry jelly into a measuring cup and now I will carefully heat it up in the microwave on low heat until it melts. Be careful not to boil your jelly. My jelly is melted and lukewarm. Now I will pour it onto the set panna cotta. I will put my glasses back in the fridge until the jelly sets again. To make twill cookies, I'll put sifted flour, sifted powdered sugar, melted butter, and egg whites into a bowl. I will mix with a whisk until I get uniform mixture. I will put half a teaspoon of the mixture onto a paper-lined baking tray and spread it with the back of the spoon into a form of a small ellipse. I will repeat the procedure until I fill the tray. Then I'll bake them at 180 degrees centigrade, which is 350 degrees Fahrenheit, for about 5 to 6 minutes until golden around the edges. My twill cookies are done and they are still hot. I will transfer them into my baguette mold and leave them to cool down like that. Once cooled, they will keep their curved shape. Instead of baguette mold, you can also use your rolling pin to create curved shape of your twills. My jelly is set. To decorate my panna cotta, first I will sprinkle some chopped pistachios onto the strawberry jelly. Then I will stick two twill cookies into the jelly. Finally, I'll place one strawberry on the top. There, my delicious strawberry panna cotta is done. Enjoy!
Oh baby, you are so sweet. So delicious and yummy. So good to eat. I wanna lick you. Feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you wanna stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And of course, visit my site, where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information, and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site, you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!